Hey, what is going on, everyone? This is your man Kingmay coming back with y'all right here in the Kingmay YouTube channel. Y'all, today we are back on the RP series, and well, we got ourselves yet another busy day here this spring. It's now middle of April. We're going ahead, we're finishing up with some silage bales here this morning. Anyways, we got chores done, cows milked, all the calves are fed up, everything is done, taken care of. So we're just getting on with our chores here for today. And well, the chores are starting to add up actually quite a bit here. As we're swinging around, we're getting these grass bales wrapped up here with our silage wrapper, our bale wrapper here, if you will. Doing this just for this first year, at least until we get some corn silage in from our corn that we planted up this spring. So this fall should be a fairly productive fall for us as far as having some corn silage in the pit ready to go, but we got to get ourselves there first. So I'm hoping that these bales kind of ferment up for me here fairly quick. But oh, busy day, we gotta get on down. We're gonna help eventually my man Buck. I'm hoping to get to that later on today. He's got a couple of fields that need to get planted up here yet, so we're gonna get down there and help him with that. Seems how we're gonna be making some hay bales here pretty quick. I'm hoping we can maybe get some of those made up today. We got to get to cutting first though, so we'll see if the weather is permitting. So very, very busy here on the RP series, y'all. So if you are enjoying the video here today, make sure you let me know by smashing that thumbs up button. And of course, if you haven't yet subscribed here to the Kingmay community, make sure you go ahead and you do that for me now, as deer are coming in the front lawn levitating. Oh, please tell me I'm not on an episode of Conjuring with deer here in the front yard. Oh, God, yeah, get out of here. Would you get out of here? The deer are spawning in everywhere around here, but I'm absolutely loving it, and I'm not going to lie. Adds a whole new perspective to the game. Just something different, you guys. Being able to see deer actually just randomly come on in, it's very cool. But it also scares me. Have any of you, let me know down in that comment section, if any of you have been driving down the road and, well, hit a deer yet? It's a little scary. Not gonna lie, it's scary in real life when it happens. They kind of come out of nowhere. You really have no time to react. And I'm telling you, it's the same thing in game. It's pretty realistic. Not gonna lie, it's a lot of fun though. But we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna keep on rocking these here bales, getting them wrapped. So I'm going to catch up with y'all here after a little bit once we get this done, because there's really not much to it, y'all. All right, so in the midst of our busy, busy day that we need to keep moving here and progressing, I just got a phone call, and I need to make a trip real quick. While I got the gooseneck trailer here on the Ford, we're going to head on down to the dealership here, and I'm going to pick up a little, well, little toy that we purchased here. And I'm really, really excited about this. Now, I also have another one that I need to show you guys. I did end up buying two of these. Seeing how they were fairly cheap, I'm going to go with it. I got a couple of, you know, bigger tractors. We got the 7R right now. We got the 8530. Those two are kind of our big horses as far as doing field work. They are really nice to have around. And, you know, maybe eventually here we'll be rocking into maybe utilizing especially the 8530 for planting, or maybe even the 7R. But for right now, I'm really enjoying the iron, you guys. I'm enjoying the older tractors, keeping it a little bit smaller. That's what we're going to do. That 8530, I'm just going to keep that primarily for tillage work. But we're going to head on down here. I'm going to show you guys the new little toy that we picked up. And I'm going to catch up with y'all once we do that. Such a beautiful looking tractor. Very, very excited to have this one. Now like I said, we got two of these. I did get one with the row crop duals on the back that we're going to be using as the planting rig. Now, very excited. This one here is from 7L Modding. Originally, this series of tractors was done up by AAA Modding in FS19. This one got converted. I believe they're working on the rest of them here and will be releasing them here. So this one is public. I will be updating the Google Doc in the description, so make sure you guys check out the description below. I will be updating that here either later today or throughout this week, so make sure you stay tuned for this one if you guys haven't found it yet already. Facebook and mod network. So I'm gonna go ahead, let's get the ramps put up. We're gonna head on back to the farm. All right, pulling on in. I'm gonna get this 4440 unloaded here. We're going to be heading on down here. We'll get some hay cut here in a little bit. So let me get this old girl unloaded, and then we're going to get the truck on back to the house. Oh, baby, I'm excited having that here on the farm. All right, let's get going. All right, so coming into the main shop, I am going to have to get this 4955 washed up here and clean. She's rather dirty from planting season here with the old 7000, but I did get the 7000 cleaned up. We are going to be using that here later on today. Showing you guys, though, the other options with the 4440. This is the other one that we ended up picking up. We did grab a rock box on the front of this one. Custom done. Very, very much loving the look of that rock box. Much more accurate. And we got the nice narrow setup with the row crop tires. We need to get the oil changed here. So I'm going to get in the cabinet here. Start grabbing some tools. And catch up with you all after a minute here. All right, just putting the extra oil back. There we go. Oil is changed, all ready to go. But for right now, I'm gonna head on down. Let's get some hay cut here. Mower hooked up. Let's go ahead and get on over to the field.
Hey, what's going on, man?
Hey, not much, Clutch. How you doing today?
I'm doing well. I got a question for you.
Yeah.
I see you're out here doing some big bales. Are you gonna be selling any of these by chance come later on this year?
Actually. Yeah, I mean, I should have plenty, so absolutely, if you need a few, absolutely.
I might need a few. We'll see this, or we'll see how this works out. But I mean, is this your only grassland right here? What do you got? What do you got? You have cattle, right? You have a bunch of cows on this farm. From when I was driving by, I saw a fairly large dairy area in the back there.
Yep. We are growing, expanding the dairy. I got three different grass fields at the moment. This is just one of my smaller ones. So yeah, okay. I got
so
plenty.
You're using all your grass fields too. You're not leasing any land out or anything like that, right?
At the moment, no. I got to kind of see how it rolls here the first year or so, and then I might lease out a field.
Okay. Well, maybe at some point, if you ever decide you need to lease something out, you know, come talk to me. I mean, you got some big lands out here. I got this tiny little farm, a little ranch out there. I need to expand a little bit at some point. So if you're ever looking to lease something, you know, come talk to me first. All right.
Absolutely.
I got another quick question for you.
Yeah.
That Quonset that's just off to the side there, up on the west side, that stone picker that's up there, you're not looking to get rid of that, are you? By chance, it's just been sitting there, like the last 2 months I've been seeing it sitting there rusting away. You're
actually
not looking to get rid of that, are you?
I did. I set it over there. I was using that one, but, you know, we kind of quickly expanded here. So I went a different route and I really didn't know what to do with it. So yeah, I mean, if you're wanting to buy it, sure.
I might be looking to buy that. That's for sure. I mean, finances are a little tight right now, to be perfectly honest.
Well, tell you what, let's do a leasing program. Cause I'm not even using that thing. I got another one. Why don't you go ahead? Just take it home with you. And I mean, I know who you are anyway, so.
I'm not going to get some random questions for favors. I let me guess. I probably am at some point in time. I'm sure of it. But you know what? If you need some help with something, I guess, you know what? We'll work something out. But that's mighty kind of you. I appreciate that. I could definitely use a little bit of work on my fields. The tiny old farm that I've got going on there, I need to clean some stuff up. That's for sure. I got one extra last little favor for you to ask, actually, then.
Yeah.
Is there any chance you could bring that rock picker over to my place?
Absolutely. Yeah, I'm just about done baling. Let me get this done, and then I'll detach my round baler. I'll bring that down to you. All right.
Oh, that's sweet. So you pretty much give it to me for free, and I'm making you drive it. Wow, this is like, it's like Amazon, only I don't have to pay Bezos anything. Perfect.
Exactly. No Prime membership here. Just yeah. No, I'll let you lease it. I mean, if you're enjoying it, if you're liking it, we'll work it out price later, man. I mean, it's gonna be fairly cheap anyways. But I mean, yeah. When you get set up a little bit more, we can talk about it then. All right.
Awesome. I appreciate that. Well, I'm gonna head home. I got a new to me horse to go take care of, get into my pen here. So I'm gonna go take care of that.
Oh, very
and
cool.
And I will see you when I see you, I guess then.
Hey, by the way, you know, I drove by your place. I happened to notice that you did have a horse. You didn't steal that horse from Spirit, did you?
No, that's, you know what? I brought that horse from Nebraska. That's Trucker. That's my long term. I've had him for years and years and years.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I just wanted to make sure it looked a lot like Spirit.
No, definitely not Spirit. That's Trucker. He's a special case, but definitely not Spirit.
All right, man. All right, I'll see you in a bit. All right.
All right. We'll see you soon, man.
All right. All right, well, we are just about done here with this hayfield, so we'll go ahead, we'll help clutch out, we'll finish this up, we'll head on, get this baler put back in the barn, and then we'll go ahead, we'll get that down to clutch so he can keep moving on with today. It's been an awfully productive day, and I've been really enjoying it. I love these days where I can get a lot done. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing hooked up here and hydraulics hooked up as well. All right, got the rock picker loaded up. Let's get that on down to clutch here without hitting any cars. All right, let's go ahead. Let's head on down there. Pulling in. My goodness, this is a beautiful, beautiful farm down in here. My goodness. Clutch has got a really nice place down here. I'm loving it. Hey, Clutch.
Hey, buddy. Good timing. I was just actually going to give you a call and see if you're going to make it down here.
Oh, yep. I was able to get her down here for you.
Awesome. Yeah, that's perfect. This is great. This is going to work out just perfect. Oh, look at this, an old 4440. This is awesome. How long have you had this tractor for?
I literally just picked this thing up today. They got them pretty cheap down at the dealership, just some used 4440s that came in. So I actually grabbed two of them. I got another one with row crop tools I'm going to be using as my planting rig here. So.
Wow, that's very cool. I like that. All right, perfect. I'm gonna grab this rock picker then for me. I'm going to get to work with this thing right away here. I got to go up top. Up on the ridge, I got some more fields up on top that haven't really been maintained for a few years, so I'm gonna go back there and take care of those.
Copy that.
I appreciate you bringing this by today, man. This is awesome.
Yeah, not a problem. Where did you want me to stick it?
Can you get around my what 20 hay bales there? Maybe just by the house for now.
Yeah, I'll try and squeeze through here and
I can move my truck out of the way. Otherwise, that's all good. But yeah, if you can do that, that'd be great.
Awesome. Yeah. All right. There we go. You should be good to go, Clutch.
Awesome, man. I do appreciate that. That's fantastic. Like I said, let me know here. I'll let you. I'm pretty sure I'll probably end up keeping this thing. So just figure out what it was worth to you. And I'll, it looks like it's been freshly painted too. So that's even better, but I love it. Cool, man.
Yeah, absolutely. Just let me know if you need anything else, man.
Awesome. Cheers, bud. Appreciate it.
Yeah, later. All right. And we are off and at it. We're down here on Buck's field. We're getting some corn planted into the ground here for him. We're just going to go ahead. We're going to knock out these end rows. And then we're going to be busting into the middle of the field here and getting this hopefully knocked out for him here today. But y'all, I am going to call this one a video. A lot going on here on the RP server. And I was really excited to get so much done today. I hope you all enjoyed watching it, and if you did, let me know. Smash that thumbs up button, leave me a comment, and hey, if you haven't yet subscribed here to the Kingmay community, make sure you go ahead and you do that for me now. It really helps me out, helps the channel out, and we got a lot more content coming your guys' way. So I'm gonna catch y'all on the next one. Peace.